Thank you, Astrid. And indeed, welcome to the Open Data at the Federal Level presentation. If you would have some questions, please just type in on the chat. If not, you can ask after the show, I would say. Not sure if the room will be closed after the presentation or if there's a possibility to keep it open for a little while. Otherwise, well, my contact details will be at the end of the presentation, so feel free to contact me on whatever medium you would find useful.
And we can leave it open after the official session.
Depends on the questions, so it's all up to you guys. So once again, thank you. For those who do not know me, I'm working for the Federal Public Service, BOSA, which is maintaining the infamous data.gov.be portal. If you haven't visited, this is our main portal. It tries to harvest as many metadata from other portals as well. So if you are looking for data that happens to be on the regional portal of Flanders or Wallonia, you should be able to find it also in our portal. But that being said, data.gov.be being maintained by the Open Data Task Force. It's a group of about four people, with people from BOSA, like me, and from DAV, ESA, so the Agency for Simplification. And as far as I'm concerned, the portal is just a byproduct. So we have full metadata product exports available of the portal itself. So if you're not interested in using the search interface, you can just download a whole bunch of metadata in XML, RDF XML, and do whatever you want with it. The most important aspect of the portal is actually the contact form. We try to apply the no wrong door principle, which means that if you would have any questions about a data set, you can just fill out the form or send me an email and we will try to help you. And that goes for federal data sets, but that also goes for regional or local data sets. So the citizen or the company does not have to know if a data set is a federal data set or a local or regional one. That's for us to find out. That being said, the portal, as you may see, it's a bit outdated. So we're going to rework it this year, and we're open to suggestions. So if you would have some suggestions to make it more easy to navigate or to make it more pleasant to the eye, don't hesitate, just send me an email and we will be happy to discuss what's possible or what's not. But we're also on Matrix, so if you would prefer to chat instead of sending email, that's also possible. We have a very informal chat room on matrix.org, so you can just join and ask your questions in French, Dutch, English, German. It's a very informal group and it's also a free medium. What did we also do? Well, there is no such thing as one portal. You may find it funny, but it's the truth. So there's also a new science, a social science portal. It's called SODA. It's maintained by the State Archive of Belgium. And it's part of a consortium of European social science data archives. So if you would like to visit the website and publish open research data, please go ahead. It's a very nice portal. The published data sets also gets an DOI, so a unique identifier that can be used for professional publications. So you can cite certain data sets with a unique identifier. There's also a new portal on transported data. As you may know, there is a directive about multimodal intelligent transport, and there has to be a national access point. And this access point is the transportdata.be portal website. You will find there all kinds of descriptions of data about transports. It also includes some data sets provided by the private sector. So, for example, companies who are sharing cars or who are renting e-bikes, that kind of transport will also be available to the transport data.be website. Please note that not all of the data is or will be open data, but at least you will get an overview there of what type of data is available, and you will have, of course, a rich set of metadata, so you can easily identify the data sets that might be useful for you. What's next? One of the more interesting parts, perhaps, is from the people from Statbel. Statbel, you may know them, it's the statistics office of Belgium. They're also very front runners in publishing open data. I think they have been publishing open data well before the term was coined. So you will find all kinds of statistics and information on their portal or their website. And they also started what they call a data lab. Now, what's the data lab? It's actually an overview of some new ways of presenting data or collecting data, or some new data sets that they